You might be wondering what happened in the previous tutorial and how I did combine the bend and array modifier. Well, in this tutorial I got you covered. We're going to be going through how I did that step by step. So we can go ahead and shift A and drop our first mesh here. Now we do have that object here, and what I did in the previous tutorial, I applied an array modifier and I applied a bend modifier as well on Z axis 360 degrees. So what's happening here, when I increase the count, I get that symmetry, procedural symmetry objects. So how does that work here? So simply the bend modifier refers to the array modifier that we took 360 degrees, okay, 15 copies divided by 360 degrees. So we get 40 degrees for each copy. Now what's happened in the previous tutorial? So for this tutorial purpose, we're gonna be going more through the tips and tricks, and yeah, let's dive in here. As I showed you in the previous tutorial, we could grab that edge loop here, and from front view I'll extrude that on Z axis. So I'll continue lifting that to that point here. Let me just go and make that height, and we can just go ahead and grab that edge loop here. Control B bubble to that point should be enough here. In my case, I'll go and give that 6 segment. I'm disable my grid here. There we go. So we have that shape here. Now I'm gonna be going to top view here. I extrude that on Y axis. Let's go ahead and grab that here from front view, extrude on Z axis, extrude on Y axis, to that point here should be enough. Let's go and extrude once more on Z axis. I'll go ahead and extrude on Y axis. Amazing. So now for that, I'll connect these here just to support that corner, and you can go and connect that here. There we go. Now I'll, as I mentioned, we could add more details here. So well, I'm gonna create that cut here by giving that 1 segment. I'll go ahead and grab the face mode. I'll push that here, negative extrude. There we go. So I'll delete these faces here on this side. Delete the faces. There we go. So what I'm gonna do as well, I would like to add 2 loops here just because we're gonna need a sharper cut here. And let's complete that here. So with this method, we could as well do that kind of cut here. I'm gonna show you what I mean. So if I add 3 loops here, just because I wanna collapse the modifiers now. Let's collapse them by applying each single modifier separately. Now we end up with that shape here. So first of all, we need to go to vertices A, move by distance. I'm gonna increase my threshold a little bit more here. And let's see, we need to hold that area here. So what I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna keep that at the minimum level, just because I don't want to ruin my geometry here. So I'll add 2 loops here. And by the way, I'll do that here as well on the on that side here. Control Z, G and Z on Z axis. Now we have that bridge basic shape here. So what I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna fill that border. And now I'll show you about technique. Let me see here. We could go to face mode, grab that edge here, or that face, I to insert. Once more, I'll right click and poke the face. I wind up with that basic shape here. So let's complete that. Once more, I'll go to front view here, grab the vertices here. We're gonna need to lift that up here, and I'll go and force a hole, control B bubble while being in edge mode. And now I'll go ahead and lift that up with the vertices. I'm gonna need to scale them down once more on Z axis. And let's go ahead and grab these here, G and Z. To get nice topology, we need to organize that step by step. So to do that, I'll dissolve my grid here. There we go. So now we get that cut here. What I'm gonna do as well, I'll go to right view now, and I'll go ahead and reverse my effect. So I grab these here while being on wireframe mode. Make sure that you do that on wireframe mode here, because we're gonna need to grab the back face as well. There we go. End up with that shape here. And now what I do here, I'm gonna need to lift these here up. So wireframe mode, I'll grab these here, lift them up together.
well.
And now we could grab the edge mode or the face mode. I'll go ahead and shift and control, select the whole loop manually. And now right click, extrude face along normals, push it inside a little bit. So now I'll go ahead and do that once more. Control R, snap one here and one here. Let's leave that area here because I want to bend that and smooth that out with the subdivision. So I'll go ahead and connect these here. By the way, we need to push that here on Z axis. S, Z, 0, line of projection, G and Z. Now we're going to add a loop here as well. So I'll push that here and one here. So now you could repeat that here. We're gonna leave it as a default and connect these here. And support this, of course. And now what we can do is, well, we get this is the same effect here. So what I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna grab the edge loop and just repeat my process here. There we go. So now I'm gonna wrap everything here while being an edge mode, control B bubble. And now face mode, we could right click, extrude face along normals. Make sure you give it a little bit of thickness, not that much. Do not make it too intense. And now we're gonna connect the bad guy and this as well. And I'll go ahead and do that here and here. One in the middle as well, and that's all about. We need to sit in that edge loop, G and Z, on Z axis, and now I'll connect these here just because I want to make sure that I have enough topology. So G and Z, control B bubble. And in my case, I'll go and put 6 segments here. Oh well, let's go and start with something simple. 3 segments. Front view again, I'm going to connect these here. So SZ0, G and Z. That almost fits that area here, so I'll leave it. And now at the end here, we need to make sure that we cap the hole here at the top as well. So control F, red fill, doesn't work with us here as mentioned. So F fill, IT insert. Right click and poke the face. So what we got here, we get an object, but we got to tweak that a little bit and make that more, more happy, more warm, not pretty boring object with flat surface here. We do have cuts. So, well, let's apply subdivision surface. Last thing last with the 3 levels on the viewport. I will put that 3 on the render as well. Tap tab, select the face mode A, right click and shade it smooth. And there we go, we end up with a nice bottle here. So I wanted to make sure that you captured the previous tutorial. And this is the target for this lesson here. And that was everything. Again, we already reached 400 subscribers. So if you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe as well and support me, as we're gonna push me further and publish more tutorials in the future. For the moment, I wish you an amazing day. Take care.